Hello, everyone who is here and everyone who is watching later. My name is Ashley, and we are here today with, of course, Dr. Jill Robbins.
Hi.
And our special guest from VOA Learning English, Dorothy Gundy.
Hello.
And Dorothy is one of our videographers, and she has just started releasing a special version of the English at the Movies video series that looks at American classic films and explains lines or quotes from these films that are important to popular culture in America. And so that is our topic for today, and we will be looking especially at the first video from the American Classic series, which is based on The Wizard of Oz. So before we go further, if we could have the participants in the lesson just tell us their name and where they are from, if they want to. I will go down the list by letters. So Alejandro, hello.
Hello.
Thank you for joining. And where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Mexico City right now.
Awesome. Well, thank you for joining. Nice to meet you.
Yes.
And Claudia?
Yes, good morning, everyone. I am Claudia, and I am from Mexico City, too. And nice to meet you, Dorothy.
Thank you. Nice to meet you, Claudia and Alejandro.
Thank you. Thank you to me.
And Imad?
Yes, I am Imad from Egypt. Nice to meet you. Okay. I'm happy Hi. to join you. Hi. Hello, Dorothy.
Hello.
Hi. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Thank you, Imad. And we have two participants without video, but Tui.
Hello, everybody. My name is Tui. I'm calling from Ho Chi Minh City. Hello, Dorothy.
Hello, Tui. Nice to meet you.
Thank you for
nice
joining us
you.
Again.
Thank you. This is my second time joining the class event.
Awesome. Thank you. And finally, we have Nadia.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Nadia. I'm from Peru. Nice to meet you.
Hi,
nice
Nadia.
To meet you.
Nice to meet you.
You're our first student, our first participant from Peru. Very cool. Thank you, everyone. So, I guess we can get started. Dorothy, can you just describe a little bit about the film The Wizard of Oz?
Sure. It was one of the first films to use color in Hollywood. The film starts in black and white and ends in color. It's part of the story. But it is considered an American classic, which means a classic is a piece of art, literature, work, a movie that is judged over a period of time to be of the highest quality and outstanding of its kind. So in essence, a classic will always be good and always make sense and always be wonderful as long as it's in existence. Mm-hmm. And that's what some of these films that we're looking at in the coming weeks and months, we'll be taking quotes from them. So The Wizard of Oz, the quote is, "We're not in Kansas anymore." And that line in the film is when Dorothy, she's the main character,
which
I think my mother must have named me after her. But she finds herself in the beginning of the film, there's a violent windstorm, and it carries her house into the air, and it lands in this place that's very strange. And Dorothy is in this place with her dog, and she said, "Toto, we're not in Kansas anymore." And
I would like to point out my
and we
today.
I have to say, Ashley is from Kansas, the state of Kansas, which is, can you show us where that is in the United States, Ashley?
I drew a map. Let me know if you can see this.
That's the United States. Yep.
So here we are on the east in Washington, D.C., and basically straight west, it's the same latitude, basically, is Kansas. I don't know if you can tell, it's a big country. To drive from Kansas or from D.C. to Kansas is about 18 hours of just nonstop driving. So it is far away. And I must say that The Wizard of Oz and that movie line is maybe the only reason people from other countries know the name Kansas as a state. And boy, do they know it. Like, everywhere I go, people say that to me. Just, you know,
we're
you
not
know?
In Kansas
You're not
anymore.
In Kansas anymore? Whenever I try, I'm like, wow. Yeah, very original.
But it has come to mean, you know, you're in a strange, or I'm in a strange place. If I, and I have said it a couple of times in my life where I'm like, we're not in Kansas anymore. And people say that in yeah. America. And I think other places, as Ashley has learned in the world as well, to describe.
I have learned. Especially British people really seem to like this expression to tell me if I'm in a different country and meet a British person, they will always say that without fail.
And did you know there's a famous bench in San Francisco on a hill that overlooks San Francisco? It's a beautiful neighborhood, but there's a plaque on the bench that says, we're, yeah, picture. Yeah,
I did not know that.
And it says, we're not in Kansas anymore.
And in Wizard of Oz, Dorothy lives with her aunt and uncle on a farm in Kansas. And the state is is very rural. There are a lot of farmers there. A lot of small towns. I will say I grew up in a big city. There are also cities in Kansas. People might not know that, but there are. So, yeah. And the powerful windstorm that Dorothy mentioned is called
a tornado.
And this is, yeah, a very powerful storm where a big storm cloud comes from the sky and makes like it's a shape called a funnel, and it causes a lot of destruction.
And Kansas has a large amount of tornadoes in a year.
Yeah. So the meaning of we're not in Kansas anymore, it's just, you feel like you are in a strange, unfamiliar, maybe uncomfortable place. So the line has kind of taken on that meaning. Dorothy, do you think the writers of the film thought that would happen? Do you think they meant it to just...
I don't see how you could predict something like that. Uh-huh. I think it was just something that developed and evolved on its own. And it's kind of beautiful. There's many things from that film that have come away that are beautiful and lasting for generations.
So we would like to ask our participants. Hi, Nadia. We can see you now. Awesome.
Hi, Nadia.
Have you ever been in a situation, maybe gone to a different place, city or country, where you have felt like you are not in Kansas anymore? If you want, you can just raise your hand or press on the raise hand button to respond. Claudia, yeah.
Yeah, well, in this way, in these days with the coronavirus situation, I think all of us feel like we are not in Kansas anymore.
Thank you, Claudia. That's why I wrote this script, because I thought people mm-hmm. must be feeling this way. I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, it's okay. And especially for my parents used to walk every day, and this situation is very difficult for them more than us, because I sometimes work at home, make home office, but my parents, they go to the market or just go for a walk, and now they are not in Kansas. They are not in Kansas anymore.
Yep.
Very good.
That's an extremely good example. I think you are right, everyone is feeling like they are not in Kansas anymore. Alejandro?
Yes. I was born in another city. I am not from here, from Mexico City. Then when I arrived here to Mexico City, I used to speak in different accents, and we used to speak very quick. Then sometimes a lot of people didn't understand when I was talking to them. And I have to repeat a lot of times the same thing. that was frustrating for me at the beginning. Right now I talking like a normal Mexico City citizen, and I feel comfortable, but after 20 years or 15 years.
Yeah. Congratulations, you've adapted.
Yes, I am adapted.
Very good.
Now, when you go back to your hometown, do you think, I'm not in Mexico City anymore?
Yes. They say that I am not from... I was born in Acapulco. Do you know Acapulco?
Yes.
Coconut sun. When my family, when I go to Acapulco with my family, they say that I am a Chilango. Chilango is the name that they say for the Mexico City citizens.
Chilango.
Chilango, yes.
Yes, very good example. Nadia, would you like?
When I traveled to a few many years ago, I traveled to Cajamarca, and I missed my mother because I traveled to with my father. It was very different for me because there was different times to wake up.
So everything was different. A little different. Your day-to-day life was different. Yeah.
Yes.
So you missed home, and I'm going to write down another famous line from The Wizard Oz that Nadia might have used in this situation. It's, there's no place like home. So
I was just thinking that, Ashley. In the movie, it's Dorothy's mission, or that's the journey of the movie, is for Dorothy to get back home. And she meets a good witch. There's two witches in the movies, a bad witch and a good witch. And they both have powers. And the good witch, her name is Glinda, is that right?
The witch.
She tells Dorothy she has to click her heels 3 times and repeat 3 times, there's no place like home. There's no place like home. And It's a beautiful part of the movie. I love it.
I often feel like that when I'm in a strange place.
Click your heels three times and there's
not that easy.
Yes. But can I tell you how the film ends?
Yeah.
Do you want to know?
Maybe. I don't know if they want to know, but yeah, sure.
Dorothy does get back home and she wakes from a dream. And so basically the whole movie was the dream she had. But she is home in bed and everything's fine. She never did go to Oz, except in her mind. But it's just brilliant. It's a brilliant film.
And it was released in
1939. Yes. And that was the first film that had, that, like I said before, that used color in Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm wondering, do you have a favorite film that you remember a line from in your life often?
Well, the most famous phrase is "Hasta la vista, baby." From Terminator.
Yeah.
I'll have to do that 1 week.
can you define what hasta la vista means for people who do not?
Yes, hasta la vista, see you later, baby.
So it's like mixing English and Spanish there.
Yes.
That's a good example.
We have a similar expression in Vietnamese. There's no place like home. The expression is không đâu bằng nhà. It means no place as good at home. And I think this idiom is because I have to travel pretty much. So when I get excited at first, but after a while, I miss home wherever I go to, even the fancy restaurant, fancy hotel, eating good food and good restaurant. After a while, I miss home so much, and when I come back my hometown, I feel like it feels like there's no place like home.
Mm-hmm. That's really nice. I feel like that when I visit home as well. So do you travel, are you from a smaller city in Vietnam?
Yes, I came from Da Lat City, a smaller city in Highland, and we got the cooler weather in my hometown, and it's very hot in Ho Chi Minh City. So when I came back to my hometown to visit my parents, it's like very refreshing.
Well, thank you. And I see Claudia has her hand raised.
Yes, I have a quote from Lilo and Stitch movie. And it's Ohana. Ohana means family. And family means nobody gets left behind or forgotten. And I like that quote because when the movie was played, I bought a little Stitch, and that Stitch speaks. And one of the quotes was that, Ohana means family.
Oh,
that's beautiful.
I have not seen that film. I've heard it's really, mm-hmm. really cute.
Yes, I recommend you to watch it. I like it a lot, and it's funny, and it's a different kind of family because they are orphans, so a new visitor came to them, Stitch, and I don't want to spoil it.
Okay. Yeah.
So Ohana Ohana is a word in Hawaiian, in the Hawaiian language. Yes. And it really has a broader meaning than the English word family as relates to people who are you're related to by blood. It's more like we're part of a larger human family. And yeah. I think...
Is that right?
Ohana, yeah.
Well, we can maybe talk about the next episode of English at the Movies. Yeah? So the phrase for the next one, which is coming up just in a matter of hours, is we'll always have Paris. And that is a line from the movie Casablanca, which is a classic in American culture. Some people say Casablanca is the ultimate all-time best movie ever made. A lot of people say that. I don't necessarily agree, but it is very good. We'll always have Paris. So in Casablanca is basically a love story, but there's many layers of other stories going on. The backdrop is the beginning of World War II and people needing to escape from Europe because it's becoming so dangerous, and they go through Casablanca. So at that time in the city, the Moroccan city of Casablanca, there are refugees, there are generals, there are spies. And in the center of this is Rick Blaine, and he owns a nightclub, and he's an American, and he owns a nightclub in Casablanca. And all these characters come through his nightclub. And but in essence, he is in love with Ilza. Yeah, he pronounces it Ilza when he talks to her. And it's very complicated, because when they first fall in love, she wasn't married, but now, and then they meet up again, and she's married now to somebody, a resistance fighter. And it's very complicated, but at the same time, it's a simple love story. And Rick and Ilza fall in love in Paris, but they have to separate eventually and go on their separate ways in their lives. And one of the ending lines of the film is Ilza says, what's going to become of us? And he said, we'll always have Paris. And but it's basically means we will have the memory of our love and the memory of our feelings for each other. And that's nobody can ever take that from us. And that's what he means. Mm-hmm.
Claudia?
Oh, Claudia. Yes, Dorothy, I want to thank you, because I really enjoy watch movies, and I will follow your recommendation. I never seen Casablanca. I think that is a very long movie, isn't it?
It's probably about 2 hours, but it is complicated. Like I said, I mean, it's simply a love story, but there's all these layers of this story too. So, but it is interesting. And if you can watch it, that would be great.
Yes, I have to. I want to watch some of classical movies. And when I was a child, I remember I saw Wizard of Oz. Maybe I have to see it again.
Definitely.
Yes, I wanted to know the meaning of line in movies.
We meant to define this. Yeah. So it's if you can see the meeting notes, it is defined in there. So a line, we use this. So it has many meanings, this word, line.
We use line in electricity as line, live light, okay?
Yep, right.
But I want this.
Yeah, so.
And I
second meaning is it means straight path.
Yep, right.
That's
a straight bar.
The meaning I know, yes.
So with another meaning of line is the words spoken in a film or the words that a certain actor speaks in a film. So in The Wizard of Oz, Dorothy has a famous line that is, "We are not in Kansas anymore." So line also means words or script.
Right. So many times actors, if they have a role, they will say, "I have to learn my lines."
Yeah.
They have to memorize their lines. So it means, another meaning of lying. Mm-hmm.
And often if they are filming and they can't remember what they are going, what they should say next, the actor or actress will shout
out.
You
mean line in script?
Script. So during movie filming, the actor might shout out like a line. It just means what are my next words? I cannot remember.
Right.
Yeah. So that's a really good question.
Thanks, Ashley. Thanks, Dorothy.
Yeah. Thank you. Well, thank you everyone for joining and for sharing your favorite lines and.
How about this? Hasta la vista.
Hasta la vista, baby. And Dorothy, thank you for joining us and coming.
Thank you so much. I hope to do it again.
Yeah, for sure. We look forward to watching more American classics
on your
series. So have a great day, everyone, or night. You are calling
thank
from.
You.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
See you guys.
See you later.
Bye.
Hasta la vista.
Hasta la vista.
Assalamu.
Assalamu alaikum.